In this section, we will measure and interpret the energy spectrum of a radioactive source. In our experiment, the energy spectrum will show us how many photons are detected and what energies these photons have. The radioactive source we use is sodium-22, as you certainly remember from section 2. And for measuring and interpreting the energy spectrum, we use one of the scintillation detectors and the measurement software. This software provides us with an output diagram, as you can see now. The output diagram shows the number of detected photons as a function of the photon energy in keV. keV is short for kiloelectron volt, which is an energy unit, as you might still remember from section 1. In the output diagram, you can see on the x-axis what energies the detected photons have, and you can see on the y-axis how many photons were detected for the different energies. In this example, there are many detected photons with an energy of 400 keV. Now back to our experiment. For measuring and interpreting the energy spectrum of sodium-22, we will use the predict, observe, explain method. This means we will first predict the experimental results based on our prior knowledge. Then we will observe the experiment. Finally, we will explain our observation. So let's start with predicting the result. Therefore, we have a quick look at the transformation process of sodium-22, which you might still remember from section 2. Don't forget that in our experiment, we will only measure photons. You don't need to worry about any other particle. So, what would you predict? Which spectrum of photon energies is produced by sodium-22? Make a prediction based on your knowledge about the transformation process of sodium-22. Did you make a prediction? Great! Now let's make an observation. I have put the radioactive source here and one of the scintillation detectors here. And now I start the measurement with the software and I let it run for 100 seconds. Remember that this output diagram shows the number of detected photons as a function of the photon energy. Our measurement is over, and this is our result. Which spectrum of photon energies is produced by the sodium-22 source? Tick the spectrum that you could observe. Did your prediction match the observation? In any case, let's explain our observation. Therefore, we have another look at the transformation process of sodium-22. The radioactive sodium atoms transform into neon atoms in an excited state while emitting a positron and an electron neutrino. When the positron annihilates with an electron, they can transform into two photons. Each photon has an energy of 511 keV. The scintillation detector detects these photons. Thus, we can observe a high number of photons with an energy of around 511 keV. This is the big peak in the middle of the output diagram. Moreover, the neon passes from the excited state into the ground state by emitting a photon with an energy of 1275 keV. The scintillation detector detects these photons as well. Thus, we can observe a number of photons with an energy of around 1275 keV. This is the small peak on the right-hand side of the output diagram. In addition, we see that a number of photons in the range of energies from 0 to around 500 keV were detected. This is the very broad mountain on the left-hand side of the output diagram. Photons in this energy range are caused by the so-called Compton effect. You might have heard about the Compton effect before, but for now we will just ignore this mountain. Instead, we will consider all photons in this particular energy range as background, because they are not really relevant for our analysis. Did your prediction match the explanation? Well done! Did you predict a different outcome? Also well done! There are no wrong predictions in science. In fact, unexpected observations are much more interesting for scientists, because it means that we can learn something new from the universe. In the next section, you will learn about coincidence measurements.